Alrighty. Welcome to your videos on reviewing for your Algebra 1 Semester 1 final. This year, this is problem 20. However, this problem shows up every year, and if you're watching this in a different year than December of 2017, you might have a different numbered problem. Let's get to it. We have a sequence below. Remember, a sequence is just a list of numbers, and although they give it to you like this, I would heavily suggest you think about this in terms of a term number, because they're asking for an nth term, and then the term number's actual value. So the way I organize this is we have our term number, which is called n, and whatever number they give you first is always your first term. So your first term in this case is 29. Your second term is 25. We have 3, 21, 4, 17, and 5, 13. And then the value of that term number, which is like the output in this case, if you look at your equations, it looks like the value is given by f of n. So if you wanted a few of these, right, we could say that f of 1, the first term has a value of 29. Or alternatively, when you plug 1 into your equation, the answer better be 29. So this actually gives you one way, and it's not the way I would suggest, but it gives you one way to check your answer or to figure out the answer for this problem. Just take each of these, plug them in for the n's, and see which one gives you 29. Then take 2, plug it in for the n's, and see which one gives you what answer? Oh yeah, 25. That's guess and check, and it's not really the way we'd like you to do the problem, but it is a nice way to check to see what the right answer is. The real way to do the problem is to understand how the sequence is set up. We do a lot of this by building block or tile patterns, and what we discover is that we have an equation where we start with some base number of blocks, and then we add n number, well, we add m times n number of blocks every single time. If you rearrange this, sometimes you're used to seeing this as mx plus b. It's the same idea. B, the base number of blocks, is always found by looking at the zeroth term, which is actually the term right before 1, right? So if we look at the zeroth term, we have to use the pattern to work backwards. So if you work backwards, we should notice maybe that we're adding 4 every time. So when we add 4 to 29, that gives us 33. What that tells us is we're starting with a base of 33 blocks. Then, if we work the other way, if we work forwards, what's happening to that base? Well, we're subtracting 4 every single time. So we're subtracting 4 per each term number. If you use the commutative property to rearrange this, we have a negative 4n and then a positive 33, and we can see that this matches A. So the trick on this is to make sure you go to the zeroth term, and you should end up with your right answer.